my stuff.
Go online.
I'm proud of anything you they do.
Go online.
I be proud blogger.
Go online.
Sonikemedia.com.
Go online.
Go check my stuff.
Go online.
I'm proud of anything you they do.
Go online.
Go online. Go online. Go online. If you want spare, then they born. Then go born you one pet. You go marry. You go die. Or no matter how you get money, no matter how rich you are, no matter how wealthy you are, one day you go die. Well, if you die, no matter what, 6 feet there, you go pay. But before you go 6 feet, then go put you for mortuary inside. Where the mortuary, it do I chill pa. It do have some people, even then they order beer, then they love, and they talk say, oh, I love beer standard. It means the mortuary inside the chill pa. Today, I'm fortunate to get one mortuary man. The only mortuary man where he work, not be only Ghana, he work across Africa. Where today they can share experience he get for mortuary inside. Things they happen, pa. Oh, we hear say pastors they go take mortuary water, they take do them own things. It be true or it not be true. Today, I go make him introduce himself, the mention name. Boss, you are welcome to the Go Online. Yeah. So, you got the coronavirus. This be how we go. We greet.
Yeah,
you are welcome to the Go Online show.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Hope you are good, pa.
Yeah, I'm very good. Very
What's
good.
Your name?
My name is Shaka Lucas. I'm a mortuary man from Kolebu. Long time I'm working there. Long time.
Talk 111 so say the followers to go know what he talk.
No.
You say your name be what?
My name is Shaka Lucas. I'm a mortuary man from Kolebu.
So Kolebu, you saw the job for Kolebu?
Yeah, not only Kolebu, many places, Rage Hospital, Police Hospital.
Ah, why they do shabu shabu from here to here?
No,
to
I'm a mortuary contractor. I'm a
So then they contract you based monthly or yearly or
no? What? It depends. If you do some work, I will collect the money because it's not any work I'm doing. I'm working, I'm washing, I'm bathing strong people like chief, native doctors, strong people. I'm working there. So it's not anybody can wash them because you have to make ready. It's not easy.
How long have you done this mortuary business?
Oh, I started the mortuary work since we were having 9 years.
9 years?
9 years, oh yeah.
How did you start?
Oh, it's my uncle. I was living with my uncle. My uncle was a mortuary man. So when I was living with him, he used to bring me the mortuary, show me a few things. Sometimes he asked me, what do you want to eat? I would say rice and meat. When I would start eat, he would bring some dead body in the mortuary. He would show me the dead body. And if you vomit what you eat, you are eating, it means that you fail the first exam. If you continue to eat what you are eating with the odor of the dead body, you pass the first exam. That is how my uncle trained me small until I started working in the mortuary without any fear in myself.
So, is this something that you wanted to do or it just came by chance?
It just came by chance because my mind was not really there. And I was still a young boy, a child by then. I don't really know the way I wanted to follow. So because I was my uncle, I was doing what he's doing, because I was living with him. That is why I started doing the job till today. I grew inside long time, I'm inside.
So from 9 years, which, are you a Ghanaian?
No, I'm a Frenchman from Central Africa.
You're a Frenchman?
Yeah, from Central Africa.
From where?
Central Africa.
Okay.
After Cameroon.
Oh, okay. So you started the
long time, I started there. Yeah, I work in Central Africa, I work in Cameroon, Nigeria, Benin, Togo. I was in Ivory Coast last time when I came back to Ghana. So long time I work inside there.
What brought you to Ghana?
What brought me in Ghana here is because here I have some few families who are here, and here still I have a way to do my job the way I will set to myself. So that is why I came in Ghana here.
Now take us through the mortuary job. So now you said at Kolebu, you work at Kolebu now.
Yeah.
Kolebu. Somebody is dead, and then they bring the person. What happens?
Oh, it depends how the person die. Is Christian or Muslim? It depends, because Muslim, when they bring a Muslim in the mortuary in the morning time, before the evening time they will take the person out because they don't leave my body in the mortuary long time. You have some people that they are case who are in the court before bury the person. You have to judge the case first in the court before bury the person. So the case can do 5 years in the court before they bury the person. No, so now we are going to do some pathology deep operation. We are going to open the stomach, open the head, commode everything who is inside, and sew the stomach back, sew the everything back.
So that are you the one who do that?
Oh, I have my boss.
Oh, he does.
Yeah, we are working together. So after that, the body can do 5 years in the mortuary without smelling. If you don't do that, when you bring somebody the mortuary with the heat inside the stomach, you will bring the maggot because air is not passing
through.
So when we do the operation, everything, we clean everything, the air will pass inside the stomach, will be like some empty ball. So by then the body can do 5 years in the mortuary, 15 years, 20 years without smelling. Because if you bury the person without the government have judged the case, you will be like you are the one that killed the person. So the government have to judge the case first to see what happened before you bury the person. That is why you have different way to take care of the body in the mortuary, different way. Some people they are changing their blood. Some people, they will bring them, they will change their blood, they will put some machine here, the machine will draw the old blood, because when you die, your blood change, you come black. So when they will come out the black blood, they will take another new blood back and replace again another fresh blood in the body. That is how they used to take care of some few people who have a lot of money in the mortuary. And the lowest people who they used to take care of them is with the formal.
But if they take out your blood, you are dead already. So if they take the blood, the blood is not circulating in the body.
Yeah.
So why are they taking?
You know, all is to maintain the body in the mortuary.
So that it will not go back.
So that it will not go back. You will not smell in. You will not be.
But the person is dead.
That is the way the person choose so that they will take care of the family member, and they have the lot of money, so they will buy the bag of blood. They will buy everything. So why are you not going to do that for him? Because it's worth of your job. That is why we are doing that.
And the more you do that, the more your pay go up, because them to the money they.
You know, in the mortuary, last time they bring somebody to the mortuary, the person was in the coma. But people was not know that the person in the coma. When they bring the person, the body, I bring the body inside the cold room. I wanted to put some injection in the body. But I discovered that the vein of the person was still shaking.
Hey, you know, it means it's not dead.
Yeah, it's not dead. You know, somebody can do 3 months in the coma, 1 year in the coma, 6 months in the coma. If you don't really know, you think that the person is dead. That is why sometimes in the mortuary, some people would wake up in the mortuary, would say, hey, somebody wake up. They would think that the person is dead before. No, somebody can be in the coma.
So
six
they do
months.
Bring some people that in the name of their dead, and then you see that they wake up.
Yeah, they wake up. So this man,
and then when they wake up, what do you do?
Oh, I don't, but I used to see a few of them, but I know that if somebody wake up in the mortuary, the person was in the coma. Because there's no way that we die and we come back again alive just like that.
It's not possible. But some people claim they die, they went to see Jesus.
Oh, like that one, it depends on them. It can be the grace of God that God did give them the grace to see some extra things. That is another issue. And but it's not everybody that die and come back alive like that. And for the man, when I bring the man in the mortuary, I wanted to put the injection. I said the vein was shaking. I called the family, the mother and the father. I said that, oh, mama, your son, the vein is shaking. You have to see what you will do. You have to bring the body back in the house. If you do 1, 2, 3 days, we will not come back alive. You have to bring the body here. You can imagine that when the mother take the body and went with the body in the house, the first day, second day, the third day, even if the person come back alive. Imagine that if to say I did not have a strong spirit to watch, to see how the body is going, to see how the vein is shaking, I for just inject the formal in the body, just like that. It could be like I'm the one that killed the person, because the person was not really dead. That is when the mortuary have to be spiritual, you have to be worshipful, because there are many, many different things which is happening there.
When you say spiritual, what do you mean?
When I say spiritual, I'm trying to say that in the mortuary, there is a good way, there is a bad way. If you want to live a spiritual life, you have to follow the good way so that you will not have any trouble at long. But if you follow the bad way, it means that you lose your spiritual sight and you follow the way that will bring you in the
bad
wrong
way, juju. Or what?
When I mean, it's not only juju is a bad way. You know, in the mortuary, we used to call Friday dead body market. People used to come in the mortuary on Friday, collect the bodies in the night. Those who are going to bury them in the village, they used to come and collect it. And now some people used to come and collect the dead body waters to go and do some few rituals. People used to,
hey, people do that.
Yeah, people do that. Last time they hold some woman in Nigeria, last time she used to use some dead body water and do some few things. You know, I'm in the mortuary long time. I used to see some few things. Even some people used to come and sleep with the dead body in the mortuary.
People come and sleep with dead body in the mortuary.
They come and sleep with dead body in the mortuary.
Learned that when you die, all the holes in the body, it close. Or?
No. Who
it's
say
not
that?
Possible.
Who say that?
It doesn't close.
No, it doesn't close. Excuse me. You see, those people who die with a sickness like HIV sickness, before the person die, you see that here like this, the sickness have sucked all the blood. in the person body.
So it grow, grow lean.
Yeah, it will grow lean. Now we in the mortuary, we used to take some cuttings. You know the cuttings, we used to put in the, open the mouth and put the cutting, push it inside the body so that here inside will come, will swell up some more, will be like the person. You know the person, the person died already, but the hole cannot close. Because inside the nose cell, they used to put sometimes the cotton in the nose. You see? You know, sometimes last time I watched a woman, it was a businesswoman, they just killed the woman with some few with gunshot. So when I bathed the woman, I discovered that when I discovered that the woman was sweating inside the courtroom. You know, you see somebody, the body was sweating inside the AC, the courtroom.
Why is it sweating?
It's not normal. You know, it's showing you that there's a mystical something which is going on, because you can never see somebody sweat inside a courtroom.
It's does not, it mean it's not that the body is not dead?
No, the body is dead, but the spirit is hungry.
When it happens like that, it means what?
When it happens, it means that the spirit is hungry.
Why?
Maybe they kill the woman to collect her property. They just kill her just like that. But physically, she's dead. But spiritually, you that you are watching her, you'll be seeing her in your dream by a different way. She'll be coming to be talking to you the way we are talking physically, spiritually. But physically, she's lying down, she's dead. There was some day, if you want to go and bury some dead body in the village, when the car spoil in the road, we used to come down and talk to the dead body and beg the body, I'm begging you, I'm not the one that kill you, I'm watching you, I'm the mortuary man. People who kill you, go in the, go and do them what you want. That is the way that we used to do them till the car will start back. Because some people will say that if you die, don't bring me in the mortuary. Why? Because in the mortuary, there is a pastor, there is a native doctor, there are different type of human being. And once you reach there, your spirit will change to another spirit again. So some native doctor will say that if you die, don't bring me in the mortuary, because you know that there is a pastor, there are people who are stronger more than himself. So if the family do not obey and bring the body in the mortuary, once the person, you see that the person will disturb the family one way or another, because the family do not respect what he said. You know, that is why the mortuary is a very spiritual place. Even to enter in the mortuary in the morning time, you that you are the first person to open the door, you have to knock 3 times first.
Why?
Yes, that is a rules and regulation. So you have to knock three times.
You every day you knock 3 times.
Yeah, if I'm the first person you're going to open the mortuary, I have to knock 3 times before opening
it. Why?
Like
why?
Why? Because I told you that the mortuary is a spiritual place. It's like a ritual place. When you reach a ritual place, they have the rules and regulation. You see, it's not only all dead body who are dead. Physically they are dead, but spiritually their spirit is turning around. You see, that is why you have to knock. Sometimes you'll be outside, you hear noise from inside the mortuary and there's nobody inside. That is why you have to knock like 3 times. They will know that somebody, some human being is coming, because them are spirit. You can hear the noise, you can feel some different thing with your muscle pull. You see that muscle pull is coming in your body, you see that your hair is standing. It's true that you will feel that some different things are coming. Because in the mortuary by 12 o'clock in the afternoon, we used to close, we used to stop to do things, because it's the time that spirits are passing.
In the afternoon?
Yeah, in the afternoon. By 12 o'clock.
In the night, in the midnight, around 12 a.m. rather than...
No, even the afternoon, by 12 o'clock in the afternoon. When sun used to shine and breeze used to blow, there are a time that bad spirit used to pass. You know, it's not easy to know like that, because before I start doing the mortuary work, the way they teach me, I sleep in the cemetery almost 1 week, 3 days.
Alone?
Yeah, alone.
With dead bodies?
No, with the person who is skipping the place.
Okay.
So we were sleeping together.
As like apprentice?
Yeah. That is the way that they will form you, they will teach you the work, they will show you so that you will not be afraid tomorrow, because what's inside the mortuary is stronger, more is powerful more than all those ones that you are seeing. Yeah, because in the mortuary there are many things. Nothing will make you smile in the mortuary, because once you look the other side, you will see some armed robber who steal, police kill them, and no family will come and look them. Once you look the other side, you will see some old women who are dead, the eyes are open, there's no family. That is why if you walk in the mortuary, you will be strong. You'll be walk your spiritual path, because what you'll be seeing every day will not be easy for you. Even to eat meat will not be easy to you to eat meat, because once you will see accidented body, people will do accident, you will see inside them are bone, you will see them are blood. You miss that if they give you meat, when we start to chew the meat, you will be like you are eating something woman part. So that is why I don't eat meat. We have things
you
that we are not
meat?
Doing. No,
why?
I don't eat meat. That is why what I'm explaining to you, because if you eat meat, I will remember all those accident people that I used
why
to watch.
You feel you are eating dead body meat?
Yeah, exactly. That is why.
But before you started this job, were you eating meat?
Oh, that I was eating meat. I was chewing meat. But when I entered the job, I started to see the true way of the work. I stopped to eat meat.
So
not only
what,
me.
You chew only fish.
No fish. If you eat meat, I eat beans. Is you have the same vitamin.
Yeah, I know.
The same. So you beans is a vegetarian meat. That is what we used
so
to.
So you
eat.
Are vegetarian.
Yeah, 100%. Yeah, it's not easy, because what you will be seeing every day, you will not be able to do like other people are doing.
Okay, recently it happened that an accident happened and they brought about maybe, let's say, 20 or 30 dead bodies. First thing, when they bring that body, what do you do first?
When they bring a dead body, I wear everything already. I have my gloves, everything. I'm ready already. I will start to bring the dead body inside the mortuary, the cold room first. I will write the name, the family name. I will meet the family people. They have some rubber thing they used to tie in their hand. Yeah, we used to write the family name, so that if you do almost 1 month, 2 months, we know how to read the family name and know the person. Because when they bring the person to the mortuary, the person change. Because the person start to be black. You will not know the difference of the person that you bring and a different of the other person. That's why sometimes they used to do some few mistakes in the mortuary. They used to, last time they give some other person dead body to another family, and they give another person dead body to another family. The thing brings a lot of trouble, because when they discover that it's not the person that they came to find who is there, it brings a lot of trouble. That is why you have to register the person first, and you have to watch the person. Check space. Normally you have to check the person's teeth. You have to count the teeth. You have to count the nails, because some people are used to cut the nails and do rough things. Used to come out the teeth. You have to check the body. What are the part of the body is complete first. After that, you come out all the cloth of the body. You give all the cloth to the
if
family.
If it's not complete, what happens?
If it's not complete, you write everything. Because that's the family complete. Is there. The family is there.
The leg is not there.
Yeah, the leg is
the
not there. Everything. Everything. You write everything there, because in the mortuary, people used to come out to do for rough things.
You think maybe allow somebody to to come and remove it for juju.
Mm-hmm.
I will go there.
So
we'll
that is
that.
Why I will first do that. After that, you take the body, you come out all the cloth of the body. All body were in the mortuary are naked, man and woman, children, young man, young boy. All of them, they are naked, because you are there the way that your mother born you. You are there, you don't wear any clothes,
that's
no pants.
The
yeah.
way he came, that's how
the
you
way he came, that is how you go. Yeah. So in the mortuary there, you have a lot of things that sometimes you used to do work, but in the night you can't sleep. Because what you are doing, some people used to come and attack you. Last I get some mochi man in the Kolegono side, one part of the body is paralyzed. Yeah, one part of the body is paralyzed, because he was saying the mochi, they have good way and bad way. It depends the way that you follow, and you will know how to do your things. So the man used to do some few things in the mortuary. He used to give some people dead body water to go and do some things. So last time the man called me to come and meet him in the house. When I went, I see the man. I see that one side of the body is paralyzed. He can't do anything. He can't walk again. He can't do any job again. That is why I'm trying to advise people that you have to check what you are doing once you are living your life. You have to follow the right way. Because if I'm here today, I have plenty of my friends who are dead today. Plenty of them, because they follow the wrong way of the mortuary work. In the mortuary, there's money anywhere. Dead body is money. Teeth dead body is money. Everything is money. But if you are not ready spiritually, the thing will come back against you.
When you say it's money, what do you mean?
When I say it's money, it means that all the hair of human being, the water of dead body, people are using it to do some practical spiritual power. That is how they get my money. Some women are taking the dead body water to practice on it, and they will use and cook food to people. You see that people will come and be eating the food. The woman will be talking anyhow, be insulting people. The food, it will not be good, and the person will wash in plate by himself. The woman will be insulting everybody, and by then you will still be buying the food. You see, that is how the power of the dead body water used to work.
You mean they use the dead body water to cook?
Yeah, they practice on it.
But so when we drink such water, it doesn't have any effect.
That
doesn't affect our health.
it will not affect your health, but it will make your, it will draw your spirit from the woman. Once you eat,
draw the, you your spirit.
Yeah,
from the woman.
Once you eat the woman food, it means that every day that you pass the place, you eat the woman food. That is how the thing used to attract people. You see that you can't pass the place without eating there. You feel like somebody, something disturbing you until you eat the food. The woman, she will be insulting you, talking to you anyhow. By then, people will be lining up and see eating the food. The same thing like those girls who are selling themselves, those prostitute girls. Them too used to come and collect dead body water, practice on it. They will use and wash them my private part. When they will come out in the night like this, all the boys who meet the girl will like to sleep with the girl. And if you sleep with the girl, you start to see that in your spirit, in your dream, things are starting to go on. There are few things who are happening. You see,
that is, means the girl has drawn your.
Yeah. That is what you.
So
you know, all
when
those,
the girls do that, to gain what?
You know,
to
all
gain
those,
favor from men or what?
No, it's not to gain favor from men, but you know, all those people are doing that. They belong in something. They are not ordinary human beings. You're occultic, because last time you know, people who are coming to sleep with dead body in the mortuary, they are not ordinary people. This is my ritual that came to do. You see, when somebody is coming to do ritual, means that the person is not an ordinary person. It's not doing the ordinary something again. The person is not really somebody like me and you, because sleep with dead body, you have to be, I don't know how to say it, you have to be very, you know, it's the ritual.
No, so I come. How do they even approach you?
Thank you very much. You see, before you come, you will see the person park his car from the other side of the road, and the person come out his shoe, come out his cap, keep inside the car. He will use empty leg, enter the mortuary. So last time the person, the one who made me, he tell me that, my friend, how are you? I'm the friend of your boss. You know that I came, I want to see something here, oh, this and this and that. And when the person go inside, he was talking to me, I tell the person that you can't go inside just like that because I'm working here, or you can, you have to tell me what you want. He said, oh, don't worry. Your boss is my friend. Anything you want to do, he will call you, he will tell you that you should not disturb me. And you will see that your boss will call you and will tell you that my friend is coming there, don't disturb my friend. You see, those type of people, they are not ordinary people. You can't pursue them in the mortuary, because if you are trying to do that, you want to pursue him in the mortuary, it will put you in a lot of trouble. Because
you can lose your job.
You can lose your job, he's your boss friend. You can call your boss and tell that your boy is a very something like that. You see that your boy will say that, okay, you are not working here again. Because you are trying to see clear in something. You know, those people, they are not ordinary people. They belong in something somewhere. So that is why what they are doing, they don't mind whatever things that they are doing. If today I'm here as a mortuary man to tell you that, it means that I see a lot of things. That is why I want some people to see about that, and they know how they will try to stop that.
Yeah, have you have any experience apart from that man who came? Do women to come?
You know, women are coming. Some people who used to come in the mortuary collect some dead body water, they come in the mortuary like ordinary people. But I used to see them outside, like they claim themselves pastors. So we don't call them pastors because we don't see them as a pastor. Me, I don't see them as a pastor. Last time, the one who came, I wanted to go to his church. It was on Sunday morning. When I start to come in the church inside, the man see me from far place. He come approach to me and call me, tell me that, my friend, we know ourselves together, so don't come and disturb. Don't come and spoil our distinct in the church here. Don't come our church. So the guy really sacked me in the church. So make I should not come and disturb my distinct in my church. Why? Because in the mortuary, when they used to come in the mortuary, they are dressing like ordinary people, but outside, when they collect everything that they want to collect, they will go outside and claim that they are pastors, they are this and this, they are that and that. Because I don't see them as the pastors. That is why.
Do you know any popular pastor that has approached you before, or any of your mortuary friends that I need dead body water to do my things?
You see, all those people, if they want to come on and collect the dead body water, they will not just see you and approach you, because they know that there's not everybody who we agree to give them the dead body water. Because once you take some dead body water and give somebody, if you are not spiritual, if you are not strong spiritually, the thing can come back against you, because you are the one that did that, the person give the person dead body water. You see, like those people used to collect dead body teeth. If you go and commode some dead body teeth and go and sell it somewhere, the person's spirit will follow you anywhere you are going. Even the thing will keep how many years ago, even the thing will keep 100 years, but one day, by all means, the person, the spirit will attend to you, because you are doing something with a spiritual thing. Yeah, somebody who die, you will go and commodity to go and sell. Even your dream, you will not have peace.
If I go to a church that the pastor uses those things to, invite members to the church, so that it will attract members to the church, how will I know?
You see, you will not know it just like that, because you have to get your spiritual power. When you are spiritual, the spiritual control the physics. And when you are spiritual, you will be able to know the difference with the light and the darkness. You see, one of the advantages of the spiritual, as I'm here now, if I see a good pastor, I will know. If I see a fake pastor, I will know. Because the spirit of the good pastor is pure. You see, there's a light inside a good pastor. When you be talking, you will see that something's lighting is coming out from him. But somebody who don't have the light of God in him, if no matter what you will say, no matter how much you will share, give people, you will see that the person don't have the light on him. That is why sometimes some people used to, some pastor can talk to 6 o'clock to 6 o'clock in the night. People will be here listening because there is a light on him. People want to listen to hear the light who is coming from him. That is why people are here listening. But if you come now, you are talking and you don't have the light on you, you don't have the direction of the spirit of God in you, nobody will listen on you. Even that you use your juju to do things, one day the thing will spoil. Because it's not the truth, it's not the real way, it's not the thing that you're supposed to do to get what you have. That is one of the things.
Let's come to your personal life. Are you married?
No, I'm not married.
Do you have a girlfriend?
I can't say girlfriend. I have some few girls that if I want to satisfy myself, I will meet them. Because the last girl that I wanted to marry, when she heard I'm a mochi man, she ran away. So I don't have any girlfriend again. I used to go in the hotel to satisfy myself with some few girls. And
are that girls prostitutes?
Yeah, something like that.
So do they know you are a mochi man?
Many of them don't know me.
They don't know you.
No,
you just go and then satisfy
yourself. Yeah, yeah.
So for how the last girl that ran away from you, which year?
I would say that last year.
How many days or months did you date?
How many months? Something like last year November.
You met her last year November?
No, she left me last year November.
And which month did you meet her?
I met her on the May.
May. Oh wow.
But when they get discovered that
May, June, July, August, September, October, November. So like 7 months. So for 7 months you didn't tell the girl that you are a mochi man?
No, the girl did not hear from me, but she hear it from my friend. Somebody call me, how far mochi man? What are you doing? The girl was trying to check
girl's house, or she was
she was in my house. So my friend came and greeted me. My friend, how far you are in the mochi work are you doing? So the girl started to check mochi man. She was not believing in the beginning, but once she realized I'm doing the job, she ran away from me. Really, she ran away because she said that she
is the girl a Ghanaian.
No, she's not a Ghanaian. She's a Togolese.
So, have you dated any Ghanaian girl before?
Yeah, but I can't imagine, because sometimes I used to meet them. Sometimes I don't used to meet them.
What do you mean? I don't get it. Sometimes you need to meet them.
Sometimes you see some Ghana girls. Sometimes you see a Nigeria girl. Sometimes you see some other girls. You know. Oh,
so how often do you go to the prostitute line, a shower line?
As in,
how often do you visit the hotel? You describe it as a hotel.
Yeah. So, you know, sometimes if I want to make myself fine, I'll go and meet them. And now by then, I will not know too much waste of time, because it's a place that I don't too like. And
why don't you like?
I don't too like because it's not really a good place. You know, most of those girls
sleeping with prostitutes is not a good place.
What I say is not a good place is that where there is good, there is bad. You know, one of those girls, sometimes they used to have some business that they call I don't know how to explain it, but those people, sometimes when you sleep with a girl, you will see that the girl will keep the condom that you use with her. You see, when you release the condom, she will try to keep the condom that you release. You know that they are doing some few black market, you know.
They are selling your
sperm to people. That is why
you don't like
I know I don't too like going, but as okay. a man, a boy, I always have to get a woman on your side.
Satisfy
yourself. Yeah, that's one. People don't know that. Many people don't know that because if you sleep with one of those girls, you still have to take the distance to go and throw it. Don't leave the distance to the girl hand because it's very dangerous.
But spiritually, is there any spiritual thing inclined? Prostitutes, sleeping with prostitutes.
Yes, because. Sleep with prostitute is there that you will start to see that how they call it, woman like some men who used to sleep the night, women come and sleep with them in their dream. I don't know how they are calling that.
Okay.
Those nightmares.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So it's through them you have a nightmare because people who are sleeping with all those Asha, we don't know them all. Some native doctor used to come, Amroba used to come, occultic men used to come, different type of people. So if the girl who sleep with occultic men to go and sleep with Amroba tomorrow, we sleep with plenty of people. You know, the spirit is different spirit in her body only. You see that the different spirit will come to be another thing again. You see, because the occultic man, if you sleep with him now, his spirit will come one, the part of the spirit will enter your body.
Okay.
That is for sure. Native doctor, the same thing. And the different way how you sleep, that is why some Asho people, they are dying because they have sickness will kill them, a lot of sickness. And you see that people are killing them anyhow. You hear that in the hotel, they cut one girl head, in the hotel, they do this, they do that, because many richer people are coming there.
Do you seek to marry one day?
Yes, why not?
How old are you now?
I'm 28 years.
28?
Yeah, 28 years. But I'm trying to see what
I've... You've done the mortuary job for more than 20 years.
Oh, since when I was having 9 years, when I was small, it's not today, long time. You see, some people, when somebody died, people used to cry. Me, I'm inside the mortuary work a long time. I see many, many things, different things, many, many things, until my mind have turned to another thing. You know, today, as for me, to see a dead body is not anything for me. But it's the fear of God that we have in our heart make us respect human being, because human being is not anything. It's like egg. You know, if egg fall today, it will break and nobody could be able again to sew the place that he have broke already.
When accidents happen, people depict so much meaning into that is the devils that they want blood to suck. And do you believe in that?
I know that devil exists and God exists, you know. But I know that it's God that created devil, but devil exists. Because it's through devil that they know the real man of God. You know, if you say that you're a real man of God, and God will send some challenges to show you, to give you, to put you inside some few challenges, so that you know that inside darkness that we know that there's light. If you own light in the daytime, you don't know the value of light. But you own the light in the darkness, you know that there's a difference. You see, that is why, as for me, that is why God created devil, to know his real servant.
Do you believe there is ghost?
Yeah, ghost exists. Why?
Why?
Exists. Well,
why,
yeah.
Why do you believe ghost exists?
Oh, I see some before.
You've seen ghost before?
Yeah. I tell you that I sleep in the cemetery when I start the mortuary work.
Oh, but I thought, okay, so are you describing those who, you've said that some spirits wake up and then walk in the mortuary. Are those people the ghost?
Yeah, they are ghosts.
They are ghosts?
Yeah, they are ghosts. Because it's people's spirit. You can see somebody the other side, you will not see the leg, you will not see the hand, but you will see the person is moving around the place.
It's a ghost.
Once you want to approach the person, you see the person is going far away from you. You see, when I sleep in the cemetery 1 week, 3 days, I see different things. I see, even see that in the night sometimes there are these things they used to shout, to make some few noise in the cemetery. You know, that's why I say it's a spiritual work. You have to work your spiritual side first before you enter inside the mortuary work. Because to bath anybody like that, you don't know them. You see that some people are occulting men, they are native doctors. You just come and bath them. And there are villages that if somebody is a chief man die, they need some two or three people to bury the chief with the people.
That thing, does it really work?
Yes. When I was working in Nigeria, that is what happened. When a strong man died in Nigeria, they are doing something they call Oro. Oro, they are mask. They are going.
When I asking if it works, I mean, do they come and serve the chief like it is explained here on earth? that oh, we are killing the person so that the person,
yes, that is why himself. That is why we are killing the people.
Do they go and,
yes, that is
you,
why
you see them serving the king.
Oh, I see. I'm working in the mortuary. Last time they breathe on dead body itself. Mm. The family bring, you get some bird who used to fly in the night. They have big eyes like this. I don't know how they call it in English, but in French they call it ibu. Mm. In French. So when the family bring a dead body, they asked us to open the mapikin stomach. The bird was here alive. So I tied the bird and put the pekin stomach, and I saw it. The family tell me that when they will bury the mason, if the bird die, the person who killed the mason will die. You see, means that different, all family have my own different way to do the maturation or something.
Mm. You see. And the person who killed the person, did someone die before they buried?
Oh no, you see, the woman just tell me that the way I did, no, when they will bring my body in the ground, if the bird, when the bird will die, the person that killed my son will die. That is my own mystical way. They believe in that.
They believe. They believe.
Some people too, when they want to bury my people, they will collect money. They will gather plenty coins or plenty money, tie in my son cloth and bury the person with the coins and the money. That is my own belief. No, each family have their own way, traditional way how they are doing things. It's not the same. That is why as a mochima I used to see different things, plenty things, you know, it's not easy.
Okay.
Last time I talked to my boss that, boss, I don't have money, I need some money to put in myself. You know what he tell me?
You say what?
He bring me in the courtroom, he tell me that, see, in the mortuary, people are not dying like before. You have to pray people die plenty, and we have plenty money. You see that my boss spiritual is went to another level. That he is asking me to pray plenty so that people will die plenty, will have a lot of money. That is why we say mortuary is a spiritual place.
In that case, I'm even confused.
You see that it's not easy.
In that case, so accident should happen.
Oh, that's from his own mind. That is what you want. I tell him that
no matter how the person will die, he doesn't care.
I tell him that
people should die.
I'm telling that boss, I know. He said, pray. You see, before people were dying before plenty, you have money. Today people are not dying again like before. You have to pray. My people will die plenty. You gotta have a lot of money. I look my boss like this, I don't even know what to tell him. And he's a man that he have children at the house. Why you not kill your children and so that people will come in plenty to for children?
This is happening.
If you see somebody, your boss is talking to you like that, you have to understand that the level of your boss is another level.
Different level.
Yeah. And what you see, those people who are selling the coffin, no?
The coffin.
Well, they are praying to, if you see, Charlie Afana, oh, my man, Mark know the pastor, people know they die plenty, see the coffin, they plenty, empty, people have to come and buy. He's praying that the market have to pass. And if you want that the market should pass, people will die plenty so that you buy, you go and bury some dead bodies. You know, that is why I say everybody have his own world that is living. We can be together here now, but we have a different vision, different world that we are, the way we are seeing is different.
Hey!
You see, it's not easy.
I've done interviews, but this one has changed my mind.
It's not easy.
It has changed my way of thinking.
Yeah, it's not easy.
So last question before we go. I hear that some people, okay, they killed me, so me too, I'm coming to kill the person who killed me. In the form of, okay, they killed me for my property. So those things, do they happen?
And yes.
Do they come back to kill those who?
Yes, they are coming back.
Have you had
back.
Any experience?
Yeah, a lot of experience. That is why I told you that I watched a woman last time that the woman, she was a businesswoman, and they killed the woman to collect her properties. When I was washing the woman in the courtroom, you know, the way I'm washing woman is different. I used to wash everybody, the woman, and washing the all over the body, even the private part. I would wash the woman. I would do put the makeup, everything.
Hey, you do makeup for them?
Yeah, I do makeup.
Is so it that the normal, they look, the they normal look, makeup our ladies put on?
Yeah, more than that one said that hey! The ladies are doing.
They look
very, very, very beautiful. So that when you see the body, you
need to be attractive.
You're attractive. Because it's not easy, because the family is afraid of the body.
Mm.
If the family is afraid, you show them that the body is just an ordinary something. Mm. It's not mystical something. People think that if somebody die, you touch the person's body, you will die the same time with the person. No. You see, that is, people have different thinking. But we as much men, they teach us that if somebody die, it's God that called the person.
Mm.
And you can't be angry against God. If God do something, if somebody die, I would think in my mind that...
So if it's accident to God that...
Yeah, that is how they teach us. Mm. That if somebody die, it's God that called the person.
Even if they kill the person for juju.
Yeah, You know, nobody have the power to kill somebody. Unless if God said that today is your time and you will go. You have to be strong spiritually before you understand that. Nobody have the power to kill somebody. There are some people that they kill them, put knife in their stomach, they not die. Some people that motor car jam them, claim on them, do this, they not die. It's only God have the power. You see, it's we that we are talking that I will kill you, I will kill you, I will kill you. It's only God can decide whether today is the day that you will go or you will not go.
Wow.
Yeah, that is why you say you have to be spiritual to know how you will work to do your things. Because may if you want to listen to men mafa, you will be discouraged. You will think that God is not existing.
I went online with his name.
Shaka Lucas the Mochiman.
I'm not able to mention the name. Mention it again.
Shaka Lucas. My name Shaka is Shaka Lucas. Lucas. Yeah,
Shaka Lucas. Yeah. Is it your nickname or your real name?
Shakal is not an ordinary name because Shakal is the name that is the name of the animal that I was impacted before entered the mortuary work.
You impacted?
Yeah.
Explain the word.
As in the animal that is working with me.
So an animal is working with you.
Something like that. You have
so
to be.
So the name of the animal is called Shakal in your country.
Yeah,
by English, it's called what?
In English, I think it's still Shakal.
Shakal.
Yeah.
Well, how does the animal look like?
Is a bush animal. It's living far from the jungle.
So they killed it and impacted it.
They did not kill him, but they collect one side of his blood. They collect one side of my blood and they mix it together.
Together.
Yeah.
And they put it in.
The animal is alive. My mother can see the animal. If I'm really sick, if he have a strong sickness which is disturbing me, my mother will go and see the animal. If the animal is sick, she know that my son is sick from where he's in.
So the animal will not die until you die.
If the animal die, I will die. Yeah, that is.
And those Shaka animals, do they keep long before they?
Oh,
die? They have a long life.
Yo, they have long life. They have long life.
But why that animal?
I don't know, but that is what they choose for me. So it will depend on your spirit. If your spirit are stronger, it will depend. It's not you that will choose.
So your second name too, Shaka
Lucas. Lucas is a family name. Is a family name.
Wow.
Family name.
So before you became a Mochiman, were you called Shaka?
No.
You were called Lucas.
Mm-hmm.
So your full name back then was.
By then my full name was Hako Lucas.
Hako Lucas.
Hako is a traditional name too. Hako Lucas. No, normally Lucas supposed to use in English supposed to use the name of Lucas. Plenty of people, but Hako you can't see Hako like that. Because it's special traditional name.
Wow. Your last words to anybody who doesn't believe there is ghost, anybody who doesn't believe in spirituality.
Oh, anybody who doesn't believe should come. I will show him. We see what they have never seen for your life, so that you will not talk again too much. I have a lot of things that I have to show. I want to show some people, but because of the way of the time, there's no too time for us to do that. But no matter how, if you want to see more than that, if you want to really see, you will come and I will show you plenty of things, a lot of things.
In case anybody wants your number,
he sees me.
He sees you.
I will mention, but now I don't. You know, I told you last time that.
Okay.
So we are together.
So if you want anything right now, we there. You know the fear who or. Oh, for fear who?
No, but nothing they have.
Shaka, they God today.
They
believe in God.
Oh, why? I believe in God.
You believe in God.
I believe in God. I believe, but believe in God doesn't mean that you will go to church every day. It's not everybody that who is going to church to do God thing. You know, if you believe in God, God is we call it from French amour. Amour means I have to love everybody to practice the love with each other. That is the one way that
but
God
you, they
like.
Go to church?
Why I'm going to church?
For where?
Oh, at Circle, yeah.
Circle?
Yeah,
I'm going to church.
How do you call him? Chris Embassy.
Pastor Chris.
Hey. Yeah, plenty, not only there, plenty. No, me, I don't choose. I'm a like man. You know, as a like man, you don't choose religion.
Okay.
You are following the good way.
Okay.
You see, just follow the good way. Because if you say that this church, I will go there, it's not all of them who are pure. It's not all of them who are good at good things.
Okay.
Even your heart inside, you can be praying, be helping people. There's another way to follow God.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks for going online with us. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Sami K Media. Follow us on social media, Sami K Media. Being it Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Let's Vibe. Call for business 020-7384-584 if you want to sponsor this show. I mean, across our social media channels, just call 0207384584. Even if you are in US, Abidjan, your country,
all over the world,
everywhere, Cote d'Ivoire, everywhere, just call, we'll hook you up. My name remains Sammy K, and it's the Go Online Show. Lockout.
Go check my stuff.
Go online.
Proud of anything you they do.
Go online.
I be proud blogger.
Go online.
SammyKMedia.com.
Go online.
Go check my stuff.
Go online.
Proud of anything.